Hey folks, Nick Mach 007 here again, and today on Jerry Springer, we'll talk about how to start a controversy in the YouTube fish tank community. Now let's just talk about better understanding LED lights. So if you haven't already seen my other videos on lighting, go ahead and do that first, or this one might be a bit confusing. And to make things easier, bam, there they are. But I know a lot of you want to get an update on this tank, and I am working on a video editing some of that together, so stay tuned. But there are plants in there, so we're moving. Today I'm going to try a little bit of a different format with my videos. I'm not going to do that with all of my videos, but I think this one lends itself to it because it's a bit more visual. So let's get this started with a demonstration. Now, say you want to design your very own custom LED lights. Now, I'm not endorsing Build My LED, but they certainly are a reputable brand, and they make for a very good demonstration for my video today. So let's go check it out. All right, so we'll head on over to buildmyled.com and we'll click on the aquarium option. Then we'll select the link for DIY Spectrum and let's configure now. So I'm going to choose some random options for this demonstration. Don't get too caught up in the actual LED design that I'm choosing here. But with my options selected, let's take a look at the overwhelming amount of information we might get. And how do we sort through all of this? Well, I think we should start with the easy ones and circle back around to the ones that might be a bit more confusing. So if we look at the graph titled PPF Spectrum in Air, we first need to understand PPF. Okay, so PPF stands for photosynthetic photon flux. And all it is if you count the photons that a lamp emits in the PAR spectrum per second, you get the photosynthetic photon flux, or PPF. Suffice to say that accurately measuring this is quite difficult. But also notice how similar it looks to a normal PAR spectrum graph you might see. But how much of that will reach your plants and at what distance? So the next several graphs show you the exact same data, but underwater and at varying distances. Most notably, you'll see that the blue end of the spectrum compared to the reds will more readily penetrate deeper water. Though honestly, you can see that just 36 inches deep, how much red is lost. Now imagine that out in a lake or an ocean. All right, now, you can simply see, assuming that all this data is accurate, that the PPF, or flow of photons, which are, remember, particles of light, per second, penetrating to various depths of water across the spectrum, across the PAR spectrum. Okay, let's go back to the top and look at the radiometric spectrum and the photometric spectrum. Now, you first need to know that radiometry is a set of techniques used to measure electromagnetic radiation. This range includes all wavelengths between 0.01 and 1,000 micrometers, and includes the regions commonly called ultraviolet, visible, and infrared light. And this is a totally different technique compared to PPF, which we already discussed, because PPF is more accurately described as a quantum technique since it's counting photons. So back to Build My LED, and notice that the radiometric spectrum is measured in watts per nanometer. Radiometry is the science that allows us to answer how much light is there. Thus, the graph provides information that answers common questions asked by hobbyists, such as, do I have enough light or do I have too much light? Does that sound familiar to those of you getting started with a planted tank? Well, okay, it should sound familiar to all of us, experienced or otherwise. But what about the next graph, photometric spectrum? And it clearly looks different, but why? Well, we need to understand the difference between photometry and radiometry, and of course we just discussed radiometry. Photometry is the measurement of light, which is defined as electromagnetic radiation, which is detectable to the human eye. So it's restricted to the wavelength from about 360 to 830 nanometers. Photometry is just like radiometry, except that everything is weighted by the spectral response of the eye. So typical photometric units include lumens, lux, and a whole bunch of other obscure forms, or terms, I should say. Fortunately, Build My LED sticks with lumens per nanometer. Now, you can see what this light will look like to the human eye by examining this graph. So hopefully that one makes a little bit more sense now. But there was one final graph that we overlooked, and that is the estimated color on the 1931 CIE diagram. Yeah, so what in the world is a 1931 CIE diagram? Before you get overwhelmed, let's just look at it. Some things should make sense right off the bat. You can see the wavelength in nanometers around the edge of the curve, starting at 380 and going all the way to 700. And right in the center of the curve, you can see temperatures in Kelvin, which we talked about in a previous video. Remember, I clicked one of those videos that I put up at the beginning? And all of this is superimposed on a graph with XY coordinates. Remember high school algebra? Certainly hope so. Okay, so let's take a brief overview of this graph now. The CIE system characterizes color by a luminance parameter, Y, and two color coordinates, X and Y, which specify the point on the chromaticity diagram. The system offers more precision in color measurement than older systems. Based on the fact that the human eye has three different types of sensitive cones, the response of the eye is best described in terms of three tri-stimulus values. However, using this system, any color can be expressed in terms of the two color coordinates, X and Y. All right, the colors which can be matched by combining a given set of three primary colors, like RGB, red, green, blue, which, you know, your monitors, your phones, or, you know, whatever screen you're looking at right now is based on. But anyway, these three primary colors are represented on the chromaticity diagram by a triangle joining the coordinates for the three colors. So looking back at the diagram again, we can now understand that at the y-axis, that the y-axis is a measure of brightness or luminance, and the chromaticity of a color is then specified by the two derived parameters X and Y. I wasn't planning on going into too much detail here, but so you know, chromaticity is an objective specification of the quality of a color regardless of its luminance, and it consists of two independent parameters, hue and saturation. Okay, let me give you a simplified version of this diagram. This shows that the approximate colors can be assigned to areas on the CIE chromaticity diagram. These are rough categories, and they really shouldn't be taken as precise, but it just gives you a ballpark. All right, now back to my example from Build My LED, and we can see that my light is white, leaning towards a little bluish, maybe a little bit greenish in there, but I think mostly bluish. So we can see that represented on the CIE diagram if you see that X. And all of this aligns with the other graphs we've already looked at. Now, just so you know, one problem of the commonly used 1931 CIE chromaticity diagram is quite obvious. The green takes up far too much landscape compared to the number of visually different colors in the region. So it's actually why this CIE diagram has been revised once in 1960 and again in 1976, though we all still seem to use the 1931 version, go figure. All right, so let's get back to the live piece and wrap this up.
While I'm no optics expert, I hope this little chat has helped you better understand all those graphs you might run into when you're choosing your own LED. And for most of us, just picking an off-the-shelf LED system is going to suffice, like I'm using here. But for those of you who want to have more control, have at it. And I hope you're now better armed to do so. Now let me leave you with one crucial piece of information. The force has a dark side, which feeds off of emotions such as anger, jealousy, fear, lust, and hate. Remember, use the force only for peaceful purposes.